This episode is brought to you by Skillshare, home to over 25,000 classes that could help you learn a new life skill. Sign up using the link below to get your first 2 months completely free. One of the biggest scientific mysteries of the modern world, and everybody's favorite space topic, is whether or not we are alone in the universe. It's a real head-scratcher, because despite the odds being tremendously in favor of life existing somewhere, we've yet to see any evidence for it. Wouldn't it be nice if there were some sort of formula, some equation to estimate the number of sentient life forms beyond Earth? Well, it just so happens that there is a formula that purports to do just that. This is the Drake equation. Proposed in 1961 by Frank Drake, the equation aims to break down one big problem, the number of sentient civilizations in the galaxy, into smaller, bite-sized mini-problems. Sounds like a handy tool. Let's break down how it's supposed to work. The full equation is written like this, with n representing the number of sentient, communicable civilizations besides Earth in the Milky Way. Then we have the average rate of star formation in our galaxy, the fraction of those stars that have planets, the average number of planets that could potentially support life per star, the fraction of those planets that actually develop life, the fraction of those planets that go on to develop intelligent life, the fraction of civilizations that develop technology that releases detectable signs of their existence, and the length of time for which such civilizations release detectable signals. Seems pretty straightforward, right? We just plug in the variables and out pops a nice round number to give us an accurate estimate of the number of alien friends we have in the neighborhood. There's just one little problem. Equations tend not to work if you don't know the variables. We'll start here. This is the variable we're trying to solve for, n. Next is the average rate of star formation in the galaxy. Okay, we have a general understanding of star formation in the Milky Way, so we can put a number there. Then the fraction of those stars that have planets, we can pretty reasonably put a 1 there, as just about every star we've observed hosts several planets. Then, Nope. We have absolutely no idea for the last 5 variables in the equation. This is a bit of an issue. There's an idea in engineering called the illusion of precision. It asserts that a calculation can only be as accurate as its least accurate input. In the case of the Drake equation, we have not one, but 5 variables that would have to be complete wild guesses in order to solve for n. This means that, no matter how accurate our first 2 inputs are, our outcome would be supremely inaccurate, and some would say useless. But what if, by some strange miracle, Earth produced a brilliant mad scientist who built a spaceship and successfully contacted each and every sentient civilization in the galaxy? That would give us n. If the Drake equation were anything like other scientific equations, we should be able to reverse engineer it and find the other variables, right? Well, no. Even if we knew n, we still wouldn't be able to determine the exact variables that were in play to generate that final number. Say there are exactly 612 sentient civilizations out there. In theory, we could just fiddle with the numbers in the equation until we came up with a set of variables that yielded n equals 612. But they would still just be guesses, and even more importantly, we don't even know the relationship between the variables. Do we just assume that we can plug in these numbers and then multiply them together? What if we've missed a step? Some critical piece of the puzzle of life that we simply don't understand? Or what if one of these variables doesn't matter at all, and we only think it does? And we haven't even mentioned margins of error. 10% of planets plus or minus 1% will yield a much different result than plus or minus 5%. So what are we left with? Nothing. The Drake equation is useless as a strictly scientific formula. All the dozens of papers that come out claiming to have solved for n are nonsense, plain and simple. But you know what? It doesn't matter, because that's not what the Drake equation is good for. The true power of this series of letters is in its ability to spark curiosity and conversation. Think about it. The Drake equation was proposed in 1961, and they had even less certainty about the galaxy back then than we do today. And yet we're still talking about it. Why? Because it's fascinating. Look at it as more of a to-do list than a formula, and you begin to see its true value. You can look at it and say, okay, we know that, kinda know that, working on that one, and so on. It helps us to quantify our ignorance of extraterrestrial life and the universe in general. It gives us a glimpse of the discoveries we'll make in the future that may pave the way to eventually finding other life in the Milky Way or beyond, or at least help us to understand the processes by which life develops in the first place. Is the Drake equation terribly useful scientifically? No, not really. Groups like SETI are doing most of the real legwork searching for extraterrestrial life. But philosophically? Absolutely. It helps to open dialogue about the search for life, and that leads to actual, concrete plans that do carry scientific significance. And that's worth a lot. If you enjoy this type of video and would like to help me make more of them, consider clicking the link in the description and trying out Skillshare. Skillshare is an awesome website that provides creators an online learning community to actively improve your skills. They have classes on everything from photography to graphic design to productivity, marketing, fine art, and more. I love Skillshare because anytime I'm bored, I can just put on a class and learn something worthwhile. A premium membership gives you unlimited access to high-quality classes on useful topics, so you can improve your skills, unlock new opportunities, and do the work you love. I highly recommend you check out this course from Polymatter. It's all about how to make animated YouTube videos, and it's amazing. Join the millions of students already learning on Skillshare today with a special offer just for you guys. The first 500 people to sign up using the link in the description will get 2 months of Skillshare completely free. To start learning amazing new skills today, visit Skillshare by following the link below.